Good morning to all of you. Yeah, you are too much nervous about me. I came late. I'm extremely sorry. With apologies, I will start, but I will not be in apologetic mode in my speech. So it's a privilege for me to talk on the ETCSO forum. It is the second such summit the Economic Times has organized. This is one of the best forum that Economic Times has developed for CISOs, DPOs, CXOs, and the data protection officers. I will try to give a perspective that Government of Maharashtra, particularly Maharashtra Cyber, is trying to do in cyberspace. So they told me to give the perspective of Government of Maharashtra in tackling cybercrime and frauds. So I will just give a brief background. From 1997, the Government of India has taken efforts to build institutions, legal instruments, processes, and enforcement mechanism to tackle the cyber crimes. As the IT boomed in 2000, so the legal instrument of IT Act was also enacted in 2000. It was for the enablement of e-commerce, especially, and transactions in cyberspace. Later on, as the field changed, and in 2008, again the IT Act was renewed. Few more cyber crimes were added. Initially, the entire legislation was not for the cyber crime. It was for enablement of IT industry for e-commerce and give them a legal base for the financial transactions in cyberspace. Up to 2010, the most of the cyber crime cases were related to phishing, identity theft, and sexual harassment of women and child. After 2010, and particularly after 2014, there is a sea change in the nature and the motive of crimes. NCRB data for last 15 years from 2002 to 2016, I studied in my PhD for cyber economic crimes. It shows that cyber crime is growing at 100% each year. So you can say that each year the figure is twice of the previous year. There are some centers of cybercrime. We can say that the cybercrime is registered more there. There is one is Mumbai, second is Bangalore, Delhi, Hyderabad, and fifth one is Kolkata. Maybe these are the metros and police is police machinery is heavily present there. The capacity building and training of the police force in metros is up to date as compared to the rural policing. This may be some of the reasons, or maybe the financial industry and IT industry is mainly situated in these metros. After trained, if you come to the motives, there are two prominent motives out of all other motives. One is illegal gain or financial gain is the prime motive. So suppose out of 100 cases, 40% cases have the motive which we say illegal gain or financial gain. So illegal gain and financial gain is pure gain for money. Illegal gain may be in terms of other products, things, or maybe the benefits which they may get from the transaction. Second is harassment and particularly abuse of IT processes, technologies for sexual harassment of women and children is near about 30%. And the rest of the cases are regarding the revenge, then hacking, then political rivalry, then defacement, or what you can say the kind of small petty crimes, we can say, which are particularly not for a particular reason. So this is the entire spectrum of motives. Now, if we see the highest percentage is of 2% of crime is one is economic frauds in cyberspace and another is women and children. So how government is tackling these two challenges? Before going to the initiatives taken by the government, I will just give a brief introduction how the trends in the cyber crimes are changing. If you pick up any magazine or any institutions who has published the trends, particularly many consulting firms and research firms have published these trends. But what you can generally observe is for last 3 years, these five trends are more prominent in particularly cyber economic crimes. First is bank heists, the robberies of bank in cyberspace. Second is ransomware. Ransomware is creating an havoc in fintech and particularly other industries who are critical to the national security. Third one is regarding phishing. A large-scale phishing industry has sprawled in some rural spaces. Fourth one is identity theft. Identity theft, which is causing the cases of business email compromise and people are losing money. This identity theft is also being used for vast other reasons also. And fifth one is data breaches. These are the five prominent type of crimes, or we can say activities, illegal activities are being carried out by the perpetrators. You will say that, okay, in India, all the industries are not fully automated or dependent of IT industry. But I will give an example. In each sector, of how these five type of crimes has happened in India too. Now first, take example of bank heist. We have faced at least 4 big bank heist cases amounting more than 500 crores. So in Cosmos Bank, the bank lost near about 94 crore rupees in a span of 2 days. Lost 80 crore in a span of 2 hours, and next transaction of 14 crores next day. So in a span of 2 days, bank lost 94 crore rupees. In City Union Bank case, that is based in Chennai, they lost 38 crore rupees in 2 transactions. The Union Bank of India have not, even though not lost all the money, they could recover the money, but transaction was near about 1,100 crores, $171 million transaction. They could recover it. The fourth one is State Bank of Mauritius. The transaction was of 149 crores. They could recover some money, but at least 20 crore they could not. So you try to understand, it's not, these stories are not from outside, these stories are all related to Indian banks. We have now studied the example of Bangladesh bank heist and how it's happened. But the same way, the same modus operandi is seen in all these 4 banks also. One is cash, ATM cash outs, and another is swept. Even though Swift is telling that their network is not compromised at all. Yes, even though we take there this claim, we need to revisit the architecture which and the ecosystem we have built around the transactions, interbank transactions. Second, the clearance time between interbank transactions need to be revisited. I will give an example. In Cosmos Bank, within 2 hours, if 80 crore rupees are withdrawn, then the payment gateways, the bank, and the alert system of that bank have something need to be revisited. Suppose, had they implemented a control that a bank with a capital of, suppose, 100,000 crores should have international transaction of this much amount. But there was no control. The Visa said that, okay, your credit limit, which is assigned to us, is no more, so they flagged an alert. Otherwise, that control, if had not been in place, bank could have lost more money. In CUB case also, bank is very small. Again, the Visa flagged the alert. Had they placed a control that, okay, in any transaction, in any country, this much amount will only be disbursed. Further amount will only be disbursed after contacting the bank officials in person, or maybe checking the CBS. But these controls were not in place. So this thing need to be revisited. So if you are from banking sector, another thing is clearance between interbank. Now in this all banks, customer has not lost money. So money is in interbank transaction, so bank has lost money. In Cosmos also, bank has lost money. But bank has to pay to the other payment gateways and other banks. So this particular aspect is related to controls and processes, which is in hand of a management and the CISOs and the CXOs of that particular institution. Another type is ransomware. So I will just give two examples of ransomware. You will feel that, oh, such kind of cases has not happened in India. There was a spurt of cases in 2017, then WannaCry came, then after 3 months, PayTech came, after 2 months, non-PayTech came, and then there are host more ransomware family that was, you know, rampant in 2017. We have not heard too many ransomware cases for last 2 months. The nation's important critical infrastructure is ports, and 17% of the port traffic was halted for at least 2 months. The JNPT, which carries near about 30% of the traffic, total seaport traffic, their entire system, which was operated by Maersk, a company which is prominent in sea traffic. Their headquarter and their Indian, countries, 17 countries, their business was affected. Their entire IT system was encrypted. Then a prominent hospital in New Mumbai, the name is Mahatma Gandhi, this hospital that is located in MGM hospital in New Mumbai, that also got encrypted. So health systems are very critical. Transportation sector, particularly sea traffic, is also very critical to the national security, but it has been affected. There are other companies who also got affected, have not reported. So, but one thing is clear in all the cases is that it is not only the technology. Where the company has lost is due to the people who were operating the system were not well aware about the threats. So in case of the Mercs, their employee clicked a mail which he or she should not have clicked. In GMR case also, the same thing has happened. So I will draw a parallel that, okay, technology and technological enablements are important, but we should not forget to enable our human resource, strengthen its capabilities and skills, so that the human resource of your company is able to tackle the cybercrime. Third type of crime, that is data breaches. That has happened, I don't think so, any company which claims that they have not till so far been breached in any way. Either their claim, they may be claiming, but they may not be aware, so they may be claiming. And those who have lost and their information is public, they are denying. But the fact is that, okay, in some or other way, there has been data breaches with major companies. And all these data breaches, the human element has failed. So I will not say that entire fault is of the human resource that were employed there. Somewhere the technology also has failed. But my trace to the company management will be to trace on skill development of the human resources that they have. Now we'll come to how the government of Maharashtra particularly is tackling such a kind of menace. Government of Maharashtra has created Maharashtra Cyber, a body to tackle the cyber crimes and cyber security. We are having an holistic approach. So we are basically differentiating between IT and cybersecurity. The people who say the IT security is only cybersecurity, then we say that, okay, this approach is eliminating many other factors. Cybersecurity is having more vast, we say, implications. The human resource, technology, legal enablement, institutional development, and tools and technologies. All these factors, all these verticals are there in the cybersecurity. If we concentrate only on the IT security, we may miss all these aspects. So those who are CSOs, if they are focusing only on technology, I just want to bring to their notice that, okay, you please also pay attention to all these other factors also. Because the approach, if we took a technology-skewed approach, we may miss the processes, technologies, and legal enablement. Because all ransomware cases, we have failed in processes and human resources, not in technology. In all phishing cases, where the business email compromise has happened, we have failed in human resource skill. In all the bank heist cases, it is the bank employee who has clicked the mail, and that malware has only, you know, laterally or maybe directly sit on their servers. So processes of the banks, legal enablements, and human resource development, these three factors are mostly ignored or given less important as compared to the technology enablement of an organization. Government of Maharashtra, through Maharashtra Cyber, we are tracing particularly these three aspects apart from technology. So to fill the gap, First, Government of Maharashtra has established cyber police stations. In each district, we have near about 35 districts and 10 commissionerates. So we have 47 total cyber police stations. Why cyber police stations? Because we need a specialized unit to tackle a specialized kind of crime. All these cyber police stations are operational. To reduce the gap between the victim who is seeking justice and the machinery who is giving justice, we need an institutional arrangement. So we created cyber police stations. To enable the cyber police stations and all other general police stations, we needed cyber labs. Because each and every time, it's not possible to carry out all kind of analysis at only central level. We need to provide some kind of enablement to the local police stations. So we have established 51 cyber labs in Maharashtra and provided state-of-the-art tools and technology to them. So in that tool, all forensic devices, tools, technologies, apart from them, social media analysis, that tools we have provided. Then, considering training of the police persons or law enforcement agencies, we have traced a lot. We have trained till so far 500 people in advanced cybercrime investigation. We took help of many organizations because here the government of Maharashtra feels that the collaborative approach with the industry and the research institutions will help. Then we have an initiative to strengthen the knowledge industry. So we started anti-piracy unit. So piracy, particularly in entertainment industry, music industry, the counterfeiting in cyberspace, and piracy, particularly in software industry, we are in first phase tracing on basically entertainment industry. So we have an arrangement with few big players and started a pilot unit. Till so far, we have shut down near about 205 websites which were carrying out piracy. The last initiative the government of Maharashtra has taken is of creating a cyber secure environment in which there are 5 verticals. One is creating computer emergency response team for Maharashtra so that the local industry, so the units which are not being accessed or are not being looked after by the CERT team and which are located in Maharashtra can be served by the CERT Maharashtra. Another, we are also establishing center of excellence in cybersecurity so that the skill gap in this field can be filled. And third one is related to big data analytics and predictive policing. So whatever data that is available, we are using for predicting a crime, for securing the society and the crimes which may happen in future. So these are the some of the initiatives the government of Maharashtra has taken. And I hope and I'm confident that Maharashtra will be foremost state to provide a secure cyberspace to industry. Government is very proactive, police is very proactive in providing security, registration of crime, and then listening to the industry challenges. I request the industry players, if they have any kind of problems, if they are facing challenges, then they may approach. We will strive to solve their problems, enable them, whatever legal instrument or whatever support from police they are required, we are ready to provide. With this, I thank the ET editor, Mr. Mishra, and their team to give me a chance to speak here on this forum. And I also thank to all the delegates who patiently and without interrupting me, they listened to me. I'm thank you very much.